referring to, let me bring up Alex Corey.
Detail of that. And finally, blood oxygen saturation. So we're actually developing right now, we're combining all of this information, all of these different variables, and giving you a health score. So that's kind of what we're working on. That's a big part of our app, taking all these variables and giving you an kind of a score at the end of it. And I want to talk a little bit about the heart rate. You might be thinking, well, everybody does this, right? So who cares? The problem with, the most popular devices that we see, they're not accurate. But I think a lot of people know that. If you don't, surprise. They could be really inaccurate. Reason being is, think about when you wear a watch, right? So you're not going to tie your watch so tight, you're not going to want to cut off circulation to your hand. So you're going to leave it a little bit loose, which is fine. That's okay for a watch, but when we're talking about fitness bracelets, the activity trackers, watches, smartwatches, we're dealing with very sensitive sensors. So if any time the sensor, is above your skin, it's moving around, you're not going to get an accurate reading. So what we've done with the compression sleeve, we've added an optimal compression, silicon on the sleeve that pushes everything together, pushes all of our sensors close to the skin. So this eliminates any kind of air gap that can get it in, inside and get a much more accurate reading. And just through our testing in-house, we tested against, pulse oximeters that give you some of the most precise, heart rate data. It was about a 99% accuracy. So a lot more accurate than your current fitness devices. This is another really interesting one. Doing an electrocardiogram. This opens up, obviously, people in this room would know, it opens up to a lot of different data, especially what we're doing with that. So, your typical 12 lead, this is what it is. That's what it looks like, your 12 lead. And you can imagine that, walking around with that 10 electrodes could be probably a little bit obtrusive, to say the least. So what we were able to do is get that number down to 2. And we did this from months of testing. We actually didn't think it would work originally, but we tested for months in different places, and we found a placement that works. And that's part of the reason why we do the sleeve. And from the ECG data, we're also doing HRV analysis. So you guys might be familiar with HRV. It's something, it's being done, but it's not being done same way. What HRV is, before I move on to that, say these are, your heartbeats, each heartbeat. What HRV measures is the distance between one set of heartbeats and the next set. So let's say it'll be the difference in change between A and B in milliseconds. And this opens up, we know that from research that the higher HRV is, that means the more change between A and B and C and so forth, the healthier you are. That's just what the HRV research tells us. And lower, if it's low, that can mean a myriad of things, which I'll discuss in the next slide. Now the difference, this is being done, except a lot of the apps that are using HRV right now are using optical sensors. So your standard heart rate monitor, the same kind of technology is what they're using. The only problem with that is optical sensors give you around 30 samples per second. And when we're dealing with heartbeats and you're dealing with the change in your heartbeats, we're talking about milliseconds upon milliseconds at a time, so every little point counts. ECG gives you 300 samples per second. So that's 10 times as many samples in the ECG recording as opposed to your optical. So that's kind of what we're doing, developing our app to do this ECG analysis, HRV analysis, based on ECG. And just, some of the things that HRV can show us is your recovery status. And this kind of goes into the next point of overtraining at the gym or whatever fitness activity you're doing. Everybody has their own unique HRV and it needs, it needs to return back to its baseline after you've worked out or after you've trained. We know because a lot of early customers of ours cyclists and runners, and they go through some crazy training. So it's really important for them to get back to fully recover, because if they don't, they go back out, that could be dangerous. So we're trying to prevent that. Detection of stress and anxiety, one of the other things that HRME can show you. Very good tool. It's not, it shows you high blood pressure. Obviously the blood pressure monitors can do that, but we know from research that your lowered HRV, this could be one of the symptoms, and we're working on detecting atrial fibrillation and arrhythmia through HRV. So there's a whole lot of different things that HRV can show you. And we're providing this through our app. You know, people at the gym, in the comfort of their own home, so we want it for you to use it everywhere and all the time. And now for the best part is that our device starts at only $129. So that's a big part of what we wanted to do. I mean, a big part of it is the technology, but we wanted to make it accessible to people, because a lot of times are on the fence of buying a certain technology. It's $300, $400, $500. So if we can give it to them, they might be willing to try it out. And that's it. Thank you.
Any questions from the audience?
Yes. Can you tell me how many times you can wash your sleeve without suffering degradation?
We say about 100 times. We haven't, we haven't really had that come up from our customers. We haven't tested it that much, but it's easily washable. It's just a device. There's a device that goes inside of the sleeve. So as long as you're taking that out, then you can wash the sleeve.
But how does it measure sleep? Like, is it acceleration?
Well, yeah, I was talking about that once today they use accelerometer data, so your movement. We're using your movement data while you sleep, as well as measuring your heart rate while you sleep, and giving you conclusions based on that. That's one of the things that we're working on with our app. So,
cool.
Yes. What about the design? So I guess the big part of the design, like I mentioned earlier, it does, like you said, it looks nice, it's pretty, but there's functionality to there's an optimal amount of compression that holds all the sensors in the device close to your skin. It keeps it from moving, so not only the compression, there's a lot of benefits to compression itself, but it keeps everything onto your skin, so the sensors don't move, and makes for better data. Another big part of it was the sleeve is the way that we allow it. It allows us to do a full-time electrocardiogram, because we get a full range, and the other electrode is just under the arm. So people always ask us, well, you don't need the sleeve, right? Well, not really. We kind of need it to do the electrocardiogram. So that's two of the big reasons why we did the compression sleeve, the compression aspect of it at the length in that area. So that I'm not sure. It's just, right, yeah. I mean, we've kind of, I don't know what you mean by medical, but there's research as to what kind of compression and what does what, because you can overcompress, right? There's a lot of compression socks that they do. It's not that level of compression. So I'm not sure if that answers. Yeah.
What about balance? How does it affect balance when you have one sleeve?
Oh, you can buy two, that's fine. I don't know. By balance.
Did you test any, like, how it affects the balance?
No, we don't do. Yeah, we don't. We don't get into that kind of analysis. Yeah, ours is just kind of body sure. I'm confused with the question.
Is there a difference between right arm versus left arm? Like blood pressure sometimes is that you have to take
you
it.
You don't do, ours doesn't do blood pressure.
Right, I know, but I'm using an example.
Right.
Sensor data basically doesn't matter.
The
job.
Yeah, right. It's the same. I mean, the ECG, if some people might know, you get the reverse image, but it still will be able to detect a lot of the same things.
So, do you require any special sensors, or this is just...
Well, the device on the one end, the one in the wrist, has the first electrode on it that's on the wrist, and the other electrode feeds through the sleeve via our proprietary conductive material. So that's how, instead of using a wire like you would see it, you know, at the hospital where they're putting the wires on you, so instead of using a wire, we're using a conductive material. So that's how the sensors work. And then other than that, optical for heart rate and accelerometer for movement. That's about it, yeah. And for blood oxygen saturation, so there's red and infrared.
Maybe a follow-up question to the question about balance. If I understand correctly, it's more about you have compression in one arm, but what about the other arm? Does that affect the measurement itself? You have different compression.
No, not that we've... If it affects the reading, if it's just on one arm.
Right, because this is closer to the heart on your left, and it's compressing your vessels, right? So does that affect the...
We've tested it for quite some time. We haven't seen any difference. I don't know.
Not discomfort, just because you have compression on one side and not on the other.
I'm only going based on, you know, what our customers are telling us. The one thing about balance is people like to have uniformity, so they buy the two sleeves, right? You can obviously just get one without the sensors in it, if that's what it. But other than that, it doesn't really affect the reading at all if it's on just one as opposed to two.
One more.
You mentioned that your study can also measure blood oxygen. Normally we know pulse oximeter are measuring blood oxygen from the finger. So where is your oximeter sensor on your sleeve? You measure from the wrist or from the arm?
We're measuring it from the wrist. And we're working on it gives us a different signal. So our engineers are working on tuning the signal for it to have the exact same reading that you would get from your finger. I don't know I'm not into a lot of the technical, but that's kind of how it works.
Okay, thank you.
So at what stage, is this still in the testing mode, or is this already?
No, we're selling on the, that's why, you know, we have our early customers, we have several hundreds, and we're getting feedback from them and what they want to see with the app. So as they give us their feedback on how the sleeve works, whether it's comfortable, symmetry, all those things that, Beth mentioned, and we're getting their feedback. If they want to see something that, you know, we haven't thought of, because that happens, they say, oh, well, I want to see this and that. So we're developing our app at the same time. So we're hoping to have our app fully complete in about a month and a half, 2 months. This one we're hoping for. We already have an Android app complete, and we're just working on our iOS. About 2 months, it'll be fully.
And the feature function will be similar.
The same.
All right, I think that's all the questions we have.
Thank you very much.